The session outline is Introduction to Social Constructivism Theories. At the end of this session, you would be able to discuss the social constructivist theories of learning. Hi friends, I would like to begin with a story of an elephant and five blind men. Once five blind men wanted to know how an elephant is, what it looks like, and they went to explore this. They went to an elephant and they started exploring. The blind man who could touch its ears said, "An elephant is like a fan." One who touched its back said, "The elephant is like a wall." One who touched its legs said, "The elephant is like a pillar." One who touched its tail said, "The elephant is like a rope." If only all these blind men would have come together and shared their experiences or perceptions about the elephant, their concept of elephant would have been different. With this note, I would like to introduce you to the concept of social constructivism. Social interaction plays a very important role in cognitive development. Simply put, many brains put together is better than one. Nowadays, teamwork, group discussions, group projects are recommended because many working together will emerge with a better project, better thinking. The idea about this kind of learning was put forward by Lev Vygotsky, who said that social interaction plays a very important role in the process of cognitive development. Let us know more about it in this particular session. Vygotsky, who is the propounder of this theory, realized that children learn language first by observing others speak that language, imitate the sounds made by them, imitate the words and sentences of others, and then gradually learns to form their own sentences. And that means that children first learn things by interacting with other people, by imitating whatever they do, and slowly then learning becomes intrapersonal. They try to apply that to express their own thinking, their own feelings. So, using language learning as an example, we can say that in almost all spheres of learning, it happens at an interpersonal level first and then at an intrapersonal level. As you can see here in the illustration, the child comes to know the use of certain words such as watering of the plants, so on from others. And then learns to use in one's own sentence. That means that social interaction plays a very important role in the learning of many things. And such a concept in which children learn things by interaction with others, especially those who know more about certain things. We call them as more knowledgeable others, and such kind of learning is called social constructivism, and the theorists are called social constructivists. While at an individual level, an individual can learn certain things, a social interaction enhances this cognitive development and takes him to a higher level of learning, because of the exposure to different perspectives which is possible with social interaction. In any particular situation, when we interact with many people, it is always possible that there are some who know more about that particular thing which is being discussed. For example, if you are to talk about certain trees which are grown in the mountains, let us say in coniferous forests, if there are people who have already lived in mountainous areas who are a part of the discussion, they will be able to throw more light on the concept of coniferous forests. Similarly, if one is talking about agriculture or composting, then a person who is already dealing with such a particular exercise will be able to contribute a lot in the form of discussion. So, if one can be talking to many people who are exposed to a particular situation, that would benefit him or her multifold than he or she would have learnt only by books or by the teacher. Example of this kind of learning is the theory given by Vygotsky, which is known as the theory of social constructivism. We have seen how social constructivism lays emphasis on social interaction, group discussion, cooperative learning, which results in enhanced cognitive development. Whenever such discussions are to be held, it is to be kept in mind that in any such discussion, the people involved will involve more knowledgeable others. The people who have better exposure to a particular situation, if they are involved in a particular group, that results in better learning for the learner. And this can happen in the family, in the community also. In the family, it can be the parents who can be the more knowledgeable other, or the peers, or uncle, auntie, or anyone in the society, even the teacher, or even a villager, or anyone who is knowing more about a particular situation than the teacher or the learner. So this theory has been a latest one and has been instrumental in bringing in cooperative learning strategies and group discussions to the forefront in the teaching learning process. Thank you.